Our next speaker is Meghan McGee. Meghan's from the Department of Nutritional Sciences. She completed her bachelor's degree at McGill University and her master's degree at the University of Ottawa. She's now a PhD candidate under the supervision of Dr. Deborah O'Connor. She's working on improving the health outcomes of children who were born preterm, and her work aims to understand the risk factors for childhood overweight and obesity. She's investigating the role of donor breast milk as a preventative measure in early life. In addition to her completing her PhD, Meghan is also the founder of the epidemiological consulting firm, EpiConsult.
Very low birth weight infants account for 1% of live births in Canada. That's 400 babies born every year, weighing less than 1,500 grams or 3.3 pounds. These fragile infants are born roughly 3 months earlier than expected and are immediately rushed to the neonatal intensive care unit. Due to recent advances in modern medicine, infants at the cusp of viability are surviving past the postnatal period and making their way into childhood and adulthood, where, for reasons unknown, are more likely to develop obesity and type 2 diabetes. We know that breastfeeding reduces a child's risk of becoming obese. However, due to several reasons related to preterm birth, up to 70% of mothers just cannot provide sufficient amounts of breast milk to support the demanding needs of their infant, and therefore a supplement is necessary. Currently in Canada, either pasteurized donor breast milk or preterm formula is used to supplement mother's own breast milk. However, the ideal supplement is currently unknown. My research leverages a very successful double-blinded randomized clinical trial in which very low birth weight infants were randomized to receive either pasteurized donor breast milk or preterm formula as a supplement to their mother's own breast milk. Today, these children are 5 years old and they have survived a terrifying start to life. We are recruiting them back to the hospital for sick children, where I help them into a device called the BOD Pod. And this device measures their fat mass, their fat-free mass, and calculates their body fat percentage. Many of these children, had they been born a decade earlier, would not have survived. This is one of the only studies to assess very low birth weight infants in early childhood, and it is the first and only study to examine the effect of pasteurized donor breast milk on body composition. We expect the immune and metabolically active components present in pasteurized donor breast milk to improve body composition in two ways: by reducing their risk of overweight and obesity, and by lowering their body fat percentage and stimulating lean mass accretion, which is crucial for motor development, for glucose metabolism, and for reducing their risk of type 2 diabetes. Because preterm formula lacks several of the important bioactive components and just doesn't stack up to breast milk, perhaps donor breast milk is the ideal supplement for these fragile infants who are at an increased risk of chronic disease in later life. Thank you.